Welcome, everyone. My name is Adam McIntosh, and today I'm going to be taking you through our Intelligent Order Routing app for Dynamics Business Central. Just before we get started, a little bit more about WebZen. We're a Microsoft Gold certified partner located in both Canada and the US. As you can see from the screen here, we've won numerous awards over the years, focusing on the SMB space mainly. We've been in business since 2000, servicing customers, like I said, in the SMB space, and that crosses Dynamics GP, Navision, Business Central, Dynamics 365 customer experience, as well as a number of other tools. If you want, check us out online at www.websan.com, as well as our page on YouTube, which has about 1.75 million views at this time. All right, let's talk a little bit more about the app itself. So when we first built the application, we were trying to deliver the automation that big companies use to know where to fulfill an order. We thought that power should be available to the SMB space. And what our app does is it allows our customers to set up rules and automation to update sales orders to be fulfilled from their preferred location. So updates can be based on any details from the customer itself or the item being sold, as well as details from the sales order header or even the detailed sales order lines. So you can set up rules to exclude or update certain orders. Everything is logged for tracking purposes, and this whole process really eliminates the manual task of determining where an order should be fulfilled from. So let's dive in and take a look at the system. All right, so here I am in the Coronis company, and the window I'm showing right now is actually the main window that we'll be operating from for today. But before we go into the details, let's look at the setup window. All right, let me pull that up. There we go. So a few quick options. We can route released orders or not, show warnings on those. We can allow orders to cross borders or not, again, showing warnings. And then we do have calculations that I'm going to show you in a second where you can calculate if there's item availability, and we can skip any steps where there is no inventory for that item. So let's go back to the previous window and we'll dive into how you set up your order routing, and we'll do that really quickly and just so you get a little bit of a feel for what we've done here. So you can see from this main window we've got three different calculations that we're doing. So the first one is we're calculating where the sales order is going to the US, and when it does, we're going to fulfill that from the main location. Next, when it is being sold to a region or a province that contains MB, Ontario, Quebec, Nova Scotia, or New Brunswick, it's going to east. So that's everywhere from Manitoba eastwards is going to go from our east location. And then on the converse, anything on the western side of Canada, so that's BC, Alberta, Saskatchewan, is going to be fulfilled from our western location. So that's the steps, and it's executing them in a priority order. So it's going to update or perform this calculation first because it's step 20, or it's the lowest priority, and then move on to the next one, and then move on to the next one from there. So if I drill into these, I'll just drill into one of them just to give you a look and feel. You can set your priorities, obviously has to be unique. That step can either update or exclude those particular orders that meet that criteria from the calculation. We just give it a quick description and we state what location it's going to be sent to. Again, these ones are the US orders, so it's going to our main US warehouse. We can filter the data on anything from this customer item, sales order, or line, as I had mentioned before. And now that I've got, now that I've said we're going to select from the sales order header, then we just select the appropriate attribute. And you literally have every single attribute available on here. So you just have to find the appropriate one. We just reuse the same names and IDs from the system. And so when that value is equal to US, we update. Okay, so again, we can update based on any attribute from the customer, the item, the sales order header, or the line. So the possibilities are quite frankly endless at that point. From here, let's go look at some of our sales orders. And so the way we envision this is your fulfillment person, your inventory person is probably going to be looking at the sales orders, the sales order window here, and then deciding which way to allocate where to allocate the orders for fulfillment. Okay, so within here, within our actions pane, we can go to intelligent order routing, which is just going to bring us back to that last window, and we can decide to execute or not. So you can see here, we had orders for first order was north, second order was blank, third order was right now it's being fulfilled from the eastern location, and so on and so forth. So you can see here, the US one probably should be going to Maine because that is US, and these ones probably some sort of mix of east and west is where they should be updated to. So if I look at these individual customers, this first customer, they are in Manitoba, I believe. Yep, so they're in Manitoba. This next customer down here, let's just confirm where they are. They're in Ottawa, Ontario. So that's already being fulfilled from the eastern location. So that one probably shouldn't update. And then ReCloud here, they're in Vancouver, British Columbia. And then Acme USA, they should be in the US somewhere. Perfect, Chicago, Illinois. So we can see logically, this one probably should go to the main location, this to the west, these three to the east. So let's go and confirm that. So we'll run the intelligent order routing update. It lets us know it's complete. We can even see a log of that information if we want. So we can see here the log of all the updates that were completed. And we can even look at some of those logs for specific time periods as well. If we want, we can even trigger this from Power Automate if you wish as well. But let's go back. You can see here those first three customers that were in the eastern side of Canada. They're now being those orders are being fulfilled from the east. The customer from Vancouver from the west and the customer from Chicago from the US main location. So you can see here quickly and easily. Updates everything for you. You've got that log of all the updates that occurred. And this looks like it was number 15. So there we go. It's found the US orders, updated that first one from north to main, then looked at the eastern orders, so updated from north to east. And then we had those three blank ones where it set it to the east, and the west. Okay. So you always have a log of what's being updated. Really cool functionality if your orders are being loaded in via, say, EDI, or you quite frankly just don't know where to fill your orders from. Really, really cool option just to select or to automatically set where they should be fulfilled from. Thank you, everyone, for your time today. If you have any further questions, please feel free to reach out to our team at info@websand.com. And you can also find more information on our website at www.websand.com. Take care.